Hello. Couple weeks ago, YouTube user William41222 asked me to make sunflower balloon. There are many variations of sunflower sculptures. Today we're going to make sunflower head. We are going to make the head basically in the same fashion as we did the caterpillar body in previously published instruction, dragonfly caterpillar. In this example, I inflated yellow balloon leaving about 3-inch flat tail. Twist the first about 8-inch bubble, lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. Twist the second about 1-inch bubble. We have made the first section or the first petal. Work the rest of the sculpture in the same fashion, making as many petals sections as it takes to make the head. Twisting bubbles of this size, it would take about 4 balloons to make the head. Yes, I have to twist 14, maybe 16 sections. Okay, I use entire balloon to make so far first 4 sections. Now I'm going to attach the second balloon to our sculpture, lock the nozzle of the second balloon with the last bubble of the first balloon. We work in the same fashion, so let's first play this part of the video clip. We can save some balloons simply by increasing size of small bubbles in each section. Also, we can change the size of large bubbles. We can make them small up to 1 inch, or we can make them really big up to entire length of fully inflated balloon. That's a way to make very large sculptures. Okay, so we're making sunflower head. It is not exactly sunflower. We can use sunflower head to make sunflower plant. I think in some of future instructions I will make center part of the flower and attach it to sunflower head. We can make the center part using different pattern fabrics, some kind of circular pattern as described in fabric 4, for example. Alright, let's get back to our sculpture. Here we have to lock the last bubble of the last balloon with the first bubble of the first balloon. Cut off the rest of the last balloon, tie off the ends. Congratulations! We have made the sunflower head. In this example, I have twisted total of 15 petals. One has to wear the head to make it look good. Here's a head with smaller size petals. Let's make variation of sunflower head. Inflate black balloon leaving about 2-inch flat tail. We are going to work in the same fashion as we did caterpillar or dragonfly body. Let's force the black balloon through the loops of yellow bubbles, the petals. Obviously, it's easier to do with larger size petals. Let's first play this part of the video clip. One thing that I noticed while working with this size petals, or slightly smaller, it's kind of easier for me at least. To pull the flat end of the balloon through the loops than the nozzle end. And again, it's much easier to do with large size petals. So here we pull the black balloon through all petals. The next step, we mark the spot where black balloon ends meet each other, twist one bubble. This bubble goes through the loops of all petals. Lock both ends of this bubble in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the black balloon. Tie off the ends. Now we hide the connection point inside of the loop of one of the nearest petals. And fix all bubbles in proper position. Spread them evenly around the circle. Congratulations again, we have made a variation of sunflower head. Instead of black, we can use yellow balloon. Instead of yellow, we can use black balloons to to make full-size wheels for your car. Example of white and yellow. In the next example, we're going to use a green hat as a base to make a pumpkin hat. To make this hat, I use 4 green balloons to twist 14 sections. Important, even number, 14. I twisted a large bubble of section about 6 inch long. I want to stress your attention again. For this sculpture, I use even number of sections, even number of leaves. Making odd numbers of leaves will distort the pumpkin slightly. I'm going to use 5 orange balloons to make pumpkin. Inflate all orange balloons, leaving about 1 inch flat tail. We are going to split each orange balloon on 3 bubbles of the same size. Lock the nozzle of the orange balloon with a large bubble of any section. Fold the orange balloon 3 times to measure the size of the first bubble. Twist the first bubble 1/3 of the balloon length. Fold the balloon again, measure the size of the second bubble. Twist the second bubble. Lock the free end of the second orange bubble with the nearest large green bubble. Now we have to cut off nicely the rest of the orange balloon. Try to keep it inflated. We're going to use this part to make the third orange bubble. Tie off the end. Make sure that you have enough air in this part of the balloon to make the third bubble of the same size as the first orange bubble. Lock the end of the third orange bubble with the next nearest large green bubble. Measure the size of the third orange bubble, twist it, and lock the free end of the third orange bubble between the first and the second orange bubbles. In this fashion, we're going to work the rest of the pumpkin. I'm going to first play the next part of the video clip. So we lock one end of each orange balloon with one leaf, and the other end of all orange balloons we lock in one lock twist at the top of the pumpkin. Also, we can make different size orange bubbles. We can make orange bubbles half size of balloon, or use entire balloon to make one bubble. We can attach orange balloons to every other green leaf, just to save time and some balloons. Now let's take a look on the top of the pumpkin. It is very hard to attach so many bubbles in one spot. Too many bubbles together creates a lot of tension and pressure on bubbles. To reduce the pressure and tension, I move every other orange bubble inside of the pumpkin. That is the reason why I want to make even number of bubbles. Okay, in our example, we made a total of 14 orange bubbles. Now just go around the pumpkin and fix all orange bubbles in proper positions. Again, every other orange bubble goes inside of the pumpkin. Let's take a look. Here's a top view, bottom view, and the side view. Also, let's fix the leaves in proper positions. I fix every other leaf in a horizontal position. To make the sculpture looks better, we can attach leaves on the top of the pumpkin. Inflate green balloon, leaving about 5 or 6 inch flat tail. Twist a chain of the first 3 about 7 inch bubbles to make 3 leaves. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Then we twist the third bubble of the same about 7 inch size. Lock the free end of the third bubble between the first and the second bubbles. Now we lock all ends of all 3 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made 3 leaves. Later we're going to split the rest of the balloon to make funny tail. Now let's attach 3 leaves to the top of the pumpkin. First we force the end of the green balloon inside of the pumpkin. Move it to the top of the pumpkin. And now we loop the rest of the green balloon around the orange bubbles and the green leaves. Fix the end of the green balloon pointing up away from pumpkin. Stretch the tip of the green balloon couple times. Split the rest of the green balloon on two bubbles. Force the last bubble to the very end of the green balloon. We have made funny tail. And congratulations, we have made the pumpkin. Here's the side view, the top view, and the bottom view. We can use the pumpkin as a standalone sculpture or as a hat. Here's a hat. Let's take one more look on what we have done today. First we have made a sunflower hat, then we made a modification of the hat, and a pumpkin or pumpkin hat. And again, in some of the future instructions, we're going to use this kind of hat or something similar to it to make flowers. You can find many beautiful flower designs online. I put together quick links to different channels, different websites at fewdoit.com webpage, balloon twisting online resources. Have fun and happy twisting!